All right, two distinct weather makers making their way through the region, one tonight, and by tomorrow morning, many of us will have some snow on the ground. This system's moving from the Minot area through the FM area and points south and east. As we go towards daybreak, a winter weather advisory posted there, and a very similar track to a storm system late Friday evening and into the morning on Saturday has watches through the same area and all the way out through central portions of Minnesota, not impacting the Twin Cities the way it looks right now if your travels take you there for the Easter holiday. Here is a look at what we have going on. Cold air up in Regina is already 4 below there, is punching southward. As it does so, there's a little narrow band of snow working its way through the central Dakotas. Temperatures here slipping into the 20s for most of our area as we head into the night hours. This system not coming with a ton of wind, but you can expect 10 to 20 mile per hour breezes as this band of heavier snow focused right here smack dab in the central part of North Dakota. It's moving south and east. Now its arm stretches out here. This is fairly light snow. We have seen some snow in the FM area this evening, but it's been very light, flurries mainly. This area is where it's heading. It's what's going on the radar. So this area in between Hutch's red lines here is where we're going to have the best chance for some pretty quick picking up totals of snow. Here's a look at our hour-by-hour forecast. Here's our band of snow as we go through the overnight hours. It makes its way to the south and east, passing through Fargo, the Southern Valley, and the South Dakota border counties. And we'll have some heavy batches of snow in there that'll accumulate pretty quickly. Now, it doesn't stick around too long. That is the very good news. And if you're up north, no snow to have to worry about at all, but the cold is going to really punch into your area. Single digit temperatures even before sunrise and below zero readings for many to start your day. By daybreak, the snow is exiting down toward the cities. There could be a light coat of snow from Fergus Falls out towards the St. Cloud area, and temperatures in the teens and single digits above and below zero up north. A little bit of shoveling, some slippery roads first thing in the morning. Then most of our Friday midday, pretty quiet, but temperatures don't get warm. We're talking teens for everybody for the lunch hour and then climbing into the 20s with snow developing out in the west in the midday hours. Doesn't arrive here until Friday evening. So if you have travel plans, the earlier you leave, the better. And this is going to be a winter storm because our wind is really going to increase as the snow increases in intensity. More on this storm system in a second. This is all what happens by Friday night. Here's a look at our snow potential for the Friday morning round of flaky weather. Right here, Southern Valley, 1 to 3 inches. Isolated places picking up 5 inches of fluffy flakes. 15 to start your day in Fargo. And as we head toward the afternoon, temperatures top out in the mid-20s. And our chance of snow increases after 7 p.m. here in the valley. Teens tomorrow afternoon, close to 30 down to the far south. As we go into the afternoon, though, that snow will be punching into our westernmost counties as you're heading home from work. All right, now let's take a look at the late evening forecast. Look at this ridiculousness moving through here. Very heavy bands of snow possible with the wind picking up 20 to 40 miles per hour. The good news is this is all happening overnight. Then it shoots out of here, leaving us with a very cold and windy Saturday. There could be blizzard conditions with this system. Some of the snow bands look like they may be a little farther south, but we're still talking about 6 to 10 inches of snow along that heavier band. Stay tuned for changes in the track, but near blizzard conditions during the overnight hours and early in the day with blowing and drifting because it'll be that fluffy white snow like this. And this is the frosty snowmare. Christine, thanks for sharing your photo. Here's a look at your forecast. As we go through our Saturday morning, the snow ends, but the wind does not, and it looks cold for your Easter sunrise services between 5 below and 5 above across the valley. And then if you're not happy with spring yet, good, because we've got, well, chances of snow every day next week.
And some people might just want it.
Man, I'll tell you what, we're taking a beating.
Yeah, we are. Thanks,
Hutch. You bet.